Hey, what it is, what it do, what up people, it's VDuz Tech, and so check it out. You want a keyboard case for your Tab S7, but you don't want to spend $150 to $200 for the official Samsung keyboard? Yeah, I don't blame you. But check it out, we got the Jellycomb 2-in-1 keyboard case. Let's dive in. Let's go! Alright, so the unboxing wasn't anything too special in the box. You get your charging cable, type C, you get your keyboard, and you get your keyboard manual. If you want, you can go ahead and pause that so you can check it out. But you know, we don't do, wait, yo, so check it out. I just happened to see this under warnings. Does this really say, let's see if you can see that. Do not put the product in the microwave. Yo. Are y'all really out there throwing keyboards in the microwave, yo? Yo, I've heard of heated blankets. I've heard of heated steering wheels. But yo, we trying to come up with heated keyboards? Come on, y'all. Hey, but that could be that new invention, a heated keyboard. I wonder if something like that exists already. Let me know if it does. But yo, here's the case. Off back, first thing I would say, yo, this has some heft to it. This boy is heavy. But you go ahead, you unfold it on the inside. You get the little foam cushion, whatever. You got the honeycomb pattern on the inside. And here's your keyboard. So the keyboard is removable. It is being held into place with a magnet. So it doesn't come out the easiest. But as you see, it does come out without the most force. Off back, you can see there's no keyboard here, so that's a trade-off, but you're also spending a third of the price. And around the keyboard, there's your on off, there's your type C charging port. Nothing on the back. The keyboard does feel pretty good, not too bad at all. Is this a sticker you can take off? I'll leave it on there for now. And so on the inside of the case, you can see this is how you position the tablet. Mode 1, mode 2, looks like mode 3. So three different ways you can put your tablet in. But let's go ahead and grab the tablet, pop it in, and see what it looks like. All right, so check it out. I've been playing around with this for about the last hour, and I can tell you off back, yo, I definitely recommend this case. Let's take a quick look around. As you can see, it adds some good bulk to it. On this side, you have your two speaker cutouts. Over here, you have your type C cutout, two speaker cutouts. When you open this flap, there's a spot right here for your S pin. And with this flap, it has a indentation on the flap so you can fold it over and you won't lose your S pin. Now, this flap isn't the most secure. It does take a little bit of pressure for it to flap off. Let's go level one. So level one, not a big deal. Let's boost it up, let's boost it up. And as you see, it does take a little bit of pressure, but it is possible. So if your bag is moving around a lot, if it's inside of your backpack, if it's moving around a lot, your S Pen may get detached somewhere in the bag. But if you're just walking like this or something, I don't think the S Pen is gonna go anywhere. But when you go ahead and open it up, There's your tablet and here's your keyboard. And so you will have to play around with where a good spot is for your tablet. I've been playing around between spot 2 and spot 3. For right now, I guess we'll stick with spot 3. And then you just go ahead and put your keyboard right here. Now the setup process is super easy. Go ahead and go into your Bluetooth settings. Come right here, turn on the mouse right here. You can see it powers up right here. And then go ahead and hit function, hold down B for 3 seconds. When you do that, you'll see the Bluetooth light starts to flash. Go ahead and go down. It should pop up as keyboard, I believe. Let's go ahead and stop the scanning. Let's scan it again. Should be popping up. There it is. Wireless keyboard. Boom. Pairing. You're good to go. Go check it out at the top, wireless keyboard. That took all of what, 5 seconds? So definitely an easy setup process. Now, in order to control the lights, all you have to do is hold down function, hit enter, and you can see there's your lights. You have 7 different colors. Go ahead and cycle through until you see the color you like. And then you just have to go ahead and stop. So let's just say we like the red one. And then you'll come down here to shift. You hold down function and you can control the brightness. So you can see there's an off position, nothing at all. So 1 click for low, 2 click for mid, 3 clicks for high, 4 for off. And just like that, you're good to go. And so, yeah, like I said, I've been playing around with it for about an hour. And yo, I have not experienced any type of lag, anything at all. Now, I'm not the fastest typer in the world, so let's call on a professional. Now, ladies and gentlemen, now that is how you type. I used to be able to type like that, but I got into a terrible typewriter accident back in the day and my fingers just ain't ever recovered. But let's check out the keys at the top. So now if you hold this down, it'll pull up your Google Assistant. But if you hold function and hold it down, you can see there goes your keyboard shortcuts. Now, if you hit search, it'll pull up your Google. And from here on, here's your screen dimness, your screen brightness. You can take a screenshot by pressing that one right there. If you press this one right here, it pulls up your on-screen keyboard. To get the shortcuts on the screens to go away, you will have to double tap it or then touch the screen after you're done. And then there's your media keys. If you hit play, it'll go to like your YouTube music or whatever you listen to music on, and it'll automatically play it from there. I'm not going to hit it because I don't want to get copywritten or have to edit out the music, but yeah, that all works just fine. Here goes your mute button and your volume down and your volume up. Now if you go, let's just hit Chrome, you can go ahead and scroll with the page up, page down. You can always hit shift to scroll down, or if you hold down shift, hit the key, you can always scroll that way also. Let's go ahead and go back home. Now, one thing I was worried about, since it is a magnet, I was wondering if it would mess with the screen. Not sure if I forgot to mention, but you do have a slot for your S Pen right here. Now let's go ahead and open up a note to make sure that the magnet doesn't interfere with the screen. So let's just say V does tech And so look, no issues, your S Pen works just fine. So that's not anything you have to worry about either. So you are good to go. And for at the price range of $50, yo, this is something you should definitely check out. Now, some people may point out, once again, that there's no trackpad. That could be personal preference. My lady says that she actually like that there's no trackpad because since she types so fast, sometimes her palm is going back and forth with the keypad. I mean, the trackpad. Can't get my words right tonight. But if you already have a Bluetooth mouse, you're good to go. You don't have to worry about that. And so, yeah, once again, this is the Jellycomb 2-in-1 wireless keyboard case. I strongly suggest you check this out. Fold it up, throw your S Pen right there. You're good to go. It's VDustTech. I'll catch you on the next one. Later.